I'm talking about how Rose Bish came to be and how I created a 5-episode web series in one day with no experience ever creating a web series. And also how I ended up shocking myself with how much I am capable of.
In the shower.
I learned that scientifically the ions of the shower somehow give you some sort of magical ideas.
Yeah, have you had other good ideas in the shower?
I have. My best ideas come either in the middle of the night or in the shower.
Okay, so you got this idea, mm-hmm. And then what?
So I got the idea and then I basically was like, let's do it.
Let's do it? Okay. So what's the next step from there? So you literally did this thing in 3 days. So you had
yes.
this idea, and then what? Right after that, you reached out to friends? What was like,
so right after I had the idea, I got out of the shower, and I was like, okay, who do I know right off the bat that would be down for this? And I knew I had 2 actor friends, Mac and Seth, shout out. I knew they would be down. So I texted them right away. I was like, hey, you guys down? I have this idea. I want to shoot it in 3 days. They're like, yeah, we're down. Without knowing much, but that's why you have good friends. And then after that, I was like, okay, I know I'm going to need a writer because I don't know how to do necessarily like story arcs and all that. So I put in my story writers, and I think like that's one of the tools that people don't realize. Like, they're like, oh, I have to have like followers to do that. And I'm like, no.
Did you expect to get a big response from people wanting to write?
No, I didn't. I didn't know if I even had any writers who followed me. I was like, sort of just like, I'm gonna post this, we'll see, you never know.
So how many people reached out when you?
I probably had like 6 or 7 people reach out that I didn't even know. And I, the one that I actually ended up going with was a girl who, her name is Lisa, and she responded right away and she said, she told me her experience, and that was really what made it helpful, because I was like, okay, this girl has experience in this, she has like a can-do attitude, and that's what I need.
Right, so had you never done a web series of this like caliber before?
No.
This is something?
No.
So had the idea, reached out to people, and just like that, you were able to build a crew of...
So this is...
I mean, how do you go from an idea to making this happen? Because I think a lot of people would want to know that, because everyone has ideas, people mm-hmm. are scared to put them into...
Yeah, so I think first of all, you look at the pool of people that you know directly. And then usually, you know, those pool of people have their own pool of people.
Right.
So use that. You know, I asked my actor friends who I know they've made their own web series. I was like, hey, do you know a videographer? They connected with a videographer.
Right, everyone's got their own little branch. Of,
exactly, yeah. So everyone has, you have this, and then the other people have this, and then, they, you know, so all you have to do is, you know, make the first move of reaching out to your group, and then any blank that you keep, that maybe they don't know someone who does sound, okay?
Right.
Maybe they don't know a videographer. Then you go on, there's also Facebook groups that are amazing that you just go on and you pick the realm that you're in. I was looking for a videographer, so I was in LA TV and film creatives. I think that was the group I posted in. I was like, hey, anyone do sound or videography?
Yeah.
Right away, I got responses, and so I ended up going with one of my one of the actors, Mac and Seth, their friend, who is a videographer, Dane, who killed it on Rose Bish.
Yeah.
But I had backups in case Dane it didn't work out. So I think also just paying attention to that they were doing it all for collaboration. I didn't pay them.
And it's LA, I guess you gotta expect.
Yeah, you gotta expect some people to do a no-show.
But so. I guess you also forget sometimes just how many people, like you're saying, are just ready and like willing to do
yes.
something like this. Because everyone wants to be a part of
yeah.
something. So I think you'd be amazed how many people actually wanna, you know.
Yeah, you would.
Like this.
It was one of the coolest parts of the entire day was like seeing how everyone was joyfully there.
Yeah.
Like no one was like, I hate Heather for making me do
yeah.
this. Like, no one, everyone just had an attitude of, of like, I'm so happy to be here. Like, it was the coolest thing ever also, like people coming in and doing their homework on the parts. Like they already had, you know, done research and like came in, some of them came in like memorizing all their lines. I'm like, oh my gosh, we just wrote this so fast. Like, but it was really cool seeing that too. That's, you know, it's a big, I don't think there's like, there's not many better feelings than seeing people, seeing your idea come to life and seeing other people fired up about it.
Right, right, that's great. So then how do you get from having all the people, the idea, what's the next step after that into like actually making it happen?
Yeah, so we had about 3 days. So that's usually not typical.
Why were you on the time constraint?
Well, we were on the time constraint for this because The Bachelor ends in like, is in like July 29th or something.
Yeah.
So I knew I had to get this thing out. I had to finish it that week. So the first episode would come out on that Monday.
Wow.
Because I wanted it to end when The Bachelor ends.
Right.
The Bachelorette. So basically the next step though, after I got these people together, was I had a day set and I was like, hey, who's available Thursday? We're all coming together and we're gonna brainstorm. So it was this big brainstorming session. And that's when we all bounced ideas off each other and sort of got like, okay, this is what we're doing. And then that's when you sort of delegate. And that's when I was like, okay, your lane is you're amazing at writing. Your lane is that you're amazing at this. Like you sort of get to know the different personalities and how we all work together. And or maybe like me and the writer, we were really into like, we knew a lot of people in the industry, so we could do the casting side. We were like, okay, we got this.
Right.
So the next day was spent alone. And I think a lot of people, they think, you know, it's like in college when you would go to the library to go do homework versus in your dorm and like just with yourself, you get a lot more done alone typically.
Right.
So I think it's really important to have like that alone work time. And so that's when we already had been delegated the jobs that we were supposed to do. And we just grinded.
Right. So what do you feel like was the key to make? Because I think a lot of people have the idea, they have like the means of doing it, but then to actually have it be funny, have it be like a happy set. How much extra work was that on top just to keep the set like a good, happy, good energy place?
So I think the most important thing is if you're heading an idea, you have to be the thermostat. You have to be the one who's like, we are going to have an amazing day.
This is who's helping us out all day, and we're gonna be a happy set because we're happy.
Yeah!
And I walked into that day and I was like, this is a happy set. Welcome to the happy set, everyone.
Yeah.
That's what we're doing. We're gonna have a fun day. We're gonna laugh. We're gonna get stuff done. We're gonna create something amazing. And I think like, trust me, there was like a lot of different personalities on the set. When you have like over 20 people on set, it's a lot. There's no way that everyone's gonna get along. But as long as you don't let that get to you and you maintain, like, you know, when something comes up, and there was an instance where I sort of had to make sure that we're all together as a team. Like, you have to sometimes be the one who checks in with people.
And it's amazing too, you were acting as one of the lead actresses and also sort of like producing, directing. I mean, you really did everything.
Well, that's why at the end of the day I was like, did that just happen?
So what, I'm curious, what did you learn as an actress, like being, because you've never like really directed or produced anything, so what was it like?
No.
What did you learn being on that side of the things?
Yeah, so I learned more. I think this is one of the most valuable things you could ever do as an actor. I didn't even know how much it would bring me by making my own web series. You'd always hear as an actor like, oh, make your own stuff, and you're like, eh, like what am I gonna do? But I think as an actor, it made me 20 times better of an actor because I could now feel for what a casting director feels like. I can now feel what a producer feels like. I can now feel what a director feels like. You almost like you actually are getting to be in their shoes or wear their hat. What is that? What's the phrase? You get to walk in their shoes, right? You get a walk in their shoes of what that feels like, and I can tell you, like, when people will goof off. I mean, I mean, it's set is fun, and I like, you know, you're having really funny times. There's funny things that happen. So sometimes actors are like, ooh, if I'm not filming, then I can like giggle with my friends. Well, there's a lot of stuff happening. I mean, you want to stay on schedule. There's locations locked in. There's, you know, people that can only be there for so long. So, I mean, getting to be in that side, like feeling that, okay, this person's laughing and goofing off, like, you all of a sudden are like, I am never going to be the actor who goofs off. Like, I will always be professional because now I get it.
Seeing it from that perspective.
I get it. Yeah.
So, did Rosebitch Bish?
Bish. By the way, guys, it was named after like a rose bush, but now it's Bish. And we all know I don't cuss.
So, Bish. So, is Rosebitch everything you kind of expected it to? Is it more, less than what you expected it to be when you were going into it?
Okay. I did want to make a whole separate video on just like this topic alone, because I think like a lot of us are always looking for like the perfect time to do an idea, or we're looking for like, you know, it's not gonna be perfect then.
That's a really good point.
And it was not perfect.
So you're saying like it's don't keep waiting for the stars to align to start like do it. I mean, you did this in what, three days? You had very little time to prepare, and you have this like awesome, funny series now. So imagine if you actually had time.
Oh my gosh, yeah.
Yeah. So the point being like don't wait.
Don't wait, and it's never gonna be the perfect time. Life is always going. I mean, also like if I actually like let myself think of like, oh wow, it's really not a great time. Like it wasn't a great time, but I just didn't even let my mind go there. I was just like, we're going.
Yeah.
The train has left the stop. We're going on this thing.
I love that. You just
and
went for it. Yeah.
And it's one of those things where it wasn't exactly how we wrote it, but I think it turned out better because I think I wasn't married to it being perfect because I knew it wasn't gonna be.
Yeah.
And so it let the moment just go. I knew it wasn't gonna be the most perfect series because I didn't have enough time to make there. It's impossible to
make
it perfect.
It's such a spontaneous thing too. Things are changing throughout the day, like on set.
Exactly. But I think it turned out perfect because I think I just didn't have like, you know, insanely high expectations. I was like, we're gonna do the best with what we have, and I'm gonna make sure to bring people together, and we're all gonna, you know, push for the same outcome of creating something awesome. And the best everyone can do is their best.
Is there anything you would do differently? I know it went really well, but is there anything you would do differently, like moving on, going into a different?
More time.
More time?
Yeah. I mean, it was crazy. I think sleep is very important to me, and I couldn't sleep. I was like, you know, I was wearing so many hats that it was like, I'm trying to do the best I can at all the hats, but I think in that amount of time, it's like impossible. Right. I don't think it's physically possible. So,
what other advice would you give people like wanting to do this? Because I think like it seems like you have this energy, like you're someone who, you know, so for someone who's maybe like a little nervous about doing something like this, what would you say, where's a good starting point, sort of?
The starting point is always just do it. And think of me saying, do it!
Bish!
Do it, because there's never gonna be a perfect time. Perfect doesn't exist. It's never, I mean, nothing will ever end up exactly how you want it to.
Yeah.
And I think really that's kind of where the magic is, because if you're not married to the fact that it's going to be perfect, then you're kind of like letting the day rip.
Yeah,
and sometimes it's so much better that way, because you're shocked, like it surprises you, where someone does something crazy, you're like, wow, I didn't even, that's so much better than what I envisioned in my mind, you know? And I think it turns out that way because you're like allowing it to. And I think there's a different energy when you're actually like allowing your day and that idea to kind of live itself. Like you're allowing your idea to make its own story almost.
Right.
You know, all you can do is foster it in the right direction, but like be open to things changing and be happy about it.
That's a good way to put it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So, moral of the story is that you are enough. You are more capable than you can imagine. You can do so much more than you imagine. And don't wait for someone else to tell you to do it. You just need to be like, I'm doing it. And do it. Do it. Bish.